All right, take out your Bibles and get your pen or pencil ready to write some notes down on the outline sheets as well. And we're getting into the book of Esther today again. We're up to lesson number 7, chapter 6, and I've entitled it, The Irony of God. And I want you to know that it's amazing that as one looks back on history, as we do through the book of Esther here, we'll find that very often momentous events hang on seeming trivialities, little things. And our story is an example of that today. For in it, we not only see the course of human history turning, but we're going to see, as I said, the irony of God and unveiled in the process here. Also, indeed, who said that God is humorless? You know, the Bible even tells us in Psalm 37, verse 13, it says, "The Lord laughs at the wicked, for he knows their day is coming." You know, God's not worried about all the ranting and pranting of the ungodly and all the shaking of the fist in the face of God. And even in our society today, all those who want to trample down Christianity and remove it from the schools and from the courts and from the executive branch and from the, well, you name it, any part of America here. God is not worried about any of those things, and we should not be worried too much about it as well. Now, within the moments of our text today, there's a lot of high suspense and, of course, sinister possibilities. Now, God, in a very light manner, in spite of that there, is like a grand puppeteer. He is moving his puppets on the stages of history and manipulating people and events to gently coincide or violently crash, you know, one or the other, in some type of climactic grandeur, and we're going to see that today, and in the same time, never violate human will. He's never going to force anybody to do anything. He's never going to force someone to do something against their will, and he allows everybody to carry out But it was a